The first thing is what to wear, of course. So we want to make sure we're coming to school extra prepared, but also even on the weekends being extra prepared. At least a heavy winter coat, a hat, some gloves for sure, and always some snow pants and some snow boots if we're heading outside for recess. Something that's really important to remember is we want to make sure that nothing is wet when we're wearing it, including our hair if we just got out of the shower, or if we fall into a puddle or our mask falls into the snow. We want to make sure we get dry as soon as possible. So if those things happen, come inside or dry off before you go outside. The second thing that I would say is incredibly important is to make sure that you're still drinking water. It's so easy to forget that we have to drink water. We're not always as thirsty when it's really cold outside like it is right now. Our bodies are working just as hard at 2 degrees as it does at 102 degrees. So we want to make sure we're being kind to it and keeping ourselves safe and warm. It's working really hard on the inside for us. We want to nourish it. The third thing is to always make sure that we know how to walk when it's really icy and snowy outside. So it's really easy to fall and slip on the ice, and then you have to come see the nurse for a bumped head or a hurt arm or a hurt leg. So we're gonna walk like a penguin. We've probably never seen a penguin fall because they know how to walk on the ice all the time. So the way that we're gonna walk is we're gonna walk kind of with our legs spread apart, and we're gonna shuffle. So we never leap, we never run, we never skip. We want to make sure our arms are outside of our pockets, never keep them inside of our pockets, because then if we fall, we just fall straight on our head. We want to make sure our arms are out. That's why we need our gloves to keep our fingers warm, and we keep them out to our sides when we're on an ice patch. We also want to make sure that we're keeping our body tilted forward a little bit. That way we're not going backwards. That's the easiest way to fall is when we slide backwards. We do need to know though how to fall, because falls happen and ice happens, especially when it's negative 10 degrees outside. When we fall, we want to make sure our arms aren't completely extended. This is a really easy way to break our arms. So we want to make sure they're tucked in, and it's easiest to fall on our shoulder, our hip, or our thigh. So try if you can to fall that way. If you fall backwards, make sure you lift your head a little bit so that you don't hit it on the concrete and the ice. Also, a few other things to remember is that you always want to make sure when you come inside, you can still slip and fall. Make sure all of the water and the slush and the ice are off of your shoes. And you always want to make sure you stay on designated paths. So you take the path that is cleared for you. If one's not evidently clear, you want to follow the one that has footsteps. A lot of them, you can tell that someone has already walked a long ways on that path. Stay on those paths if you can, and always make sure you're never reading, watching videos, maybe like this one, or texting with your friends while you're walking. Always pay attention to where you're going. These three tips can help you stay safe and warm and hopefully out of the nurse's office this year.